This is fast. Jeez Louise, man. Okay. Alright. Talkor's an interesting character. Pop that again. Ooh, we got this bad boy. Damage could be good. Attack speed could be good. Projectile speed could be good. I think I'm gonna go with projectile speed. Just so the coins fly faster. I mean, because damage, like, let's be honest, we're one-shotting. Yo, 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 everybody, what's going on? It's Lodious here, back with another Nordic Ashes run. I'm excited for this one. Hopefully you guys are as well. If you guys are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Every little bit counts. It does show 95% of you guys are not subscribed. Also, if you guys end up enjoying, make sure you guys tap that like button down below and tap that bell notification and notify when a new video goes live, as we do upload every single day. So without further ado, let's jump right on into this. We are playing Talkor. So gold is health. Very interesting. Y'all have barely been waiting for this. So yeah, we're going to jump right on into this and see what it's all about. Since we haven't played him yet. So, yeah, let's jump right on in and see what we can do with him in Midgar. Oh, interesting. Right out the gate. So we throw coins, okay. We have two hearts, it looks like. Oh, every 5 gold is half. Every 5 gold is half a heart. Yikes, so you never want to hit 0 gold. Okay, this is going to be interesting. What's his skills here? So gold is the only one. There's no other paths. XP, XP. Gain cooldown effect power for each gold coin you have. Attack speed and area for each gold coin you have. Both could be very interesting. Each time you collect gold, it will explode, dealing damage plus your current gold value. It may also burn. Coins create pools of fire. So it looks like you can go fire or gold bomb. Very versatile little friend. There's a 25% chance that when gold drops, another extra gold will drop. Okay. Killing 250 enemies guarantees a gold drop. All right. Your pockets have no bottom, but coins only last for 2.75 seconds on the ground. Oof. All potions dropped by enemies or crates will turn into gold potions. Open the chest and receive a reward. It will be a relic, a rune, a chest, an artifact, or gold. Okay. Okay. Well, let's go with damage, probably. Get XP, of course. XP attraction. So, okay, this is very interesting. So it looks like we can get a lot of gold. The bottomless pockets make it interesting. It definitely makes it a little worrisome because I don't want to... I don't want to not buy relics. So that's what makes it interesting here. Okay. It's not bad. Alright. So we definitely need to just pick up gold. Gold and XP, baby. Gold and XP. So let's max out XP. This is interesting, but this is also interesting. I think I'm gonna go with this one though. I might go with the explosion. I think I'm gonna go with the explosion. Even though the pool of fire one sounds very cool, we'll try that one in the next Talkor run. He's very interesting because like you can only go one route with him. There is no, there's just no other way to go. So that makes it very, interesting. I'm curious on what the, and changing all potions to gold potions is actually worth it? Because regular potions don't matter for us. Like, I just picked up a blue potion and did absolutely nothing. Okay. I don't think I really want that. I mean, I do, but not right now. I definitely can't take it now. Yeah, let's grab this. Probably should have went with one of these. We might end up actually dying here. Let's hope not. Let's make it up to the gold mine. Okay. We do have a cooldown and a crit. Altar, shrine, whatever you may want to call it. Oh, we lost gold when we got hit there. Okay. I want to get hit just to see what happens again. So we have 4 XP. Attack speed and area. Cooldown and effect prob. Duration and projectile speed. I think I'm going to go this one, actually. I want to get this. Let's see what this ascension is. The power of gold. The gold requirement for upgrades is reduced by 50%, and 2 new upgrades are added to the list. Okay. Holy crap. Throw coins at your enemies. The more gold you have, the stronger your attacks will be. 3+1 projectile, 5+1 penetration, 8, 30% area, 10, 1 duration, 13 is 10% crit, 40 attack speed, 30 cooldown, 3 projectiles, 3 penetration, 45, 100%, 5 coins, coins from the sky, enemies have a 15% chance of exploding into gold coins. So it looks like we want to try and get 90 gold coins. If possible. Alright, let's see here then. Okay. That's a good one. Grab you. Grab you. The potions probably wouldn't be a bad one either. Getting the gold potions and then just running around getting potions. I wonder though, now if we get bottomless bag and we go potions, does that mean gold, the potions will only last for 2.75 seconds as well? I wonder. That's the only one way to find out. We shall see. You're up to 23 gold. I am starting to see a little bit of a difference going on here with the way we're throwing things. Okay. I'm a little worried about the bosses, though. The bosses will be interesting to fight. Okay. Not really too worried about this guy. Okay. I mean, just getting another projectile might not be bad, going for that other one, but we don't really have the health to do so right now. That's why I didn't cross over to get that relic, because we will take damage. So, just running around, seeing it, if we can find any more crates that are near us to get as much gold as possible. It does look like monsters do drop, have a chance to drop some coins, which is always good. Okay. I mean, we have 16, we might as well actually spend them. So let's get damage, of course. Let's get this one. Let's get cooldown. I do want to get this, though. Oh, that just lowers the time. I'll take you. Look at that. Gold. I don't know how much... I wasn't paying attention to see how many coins we got. I think we got 5 out of that. Okay, we're already on the boss. This boss I'm not too worried about. The big rock one is a little worrisome. Okay. Damn it. So we lost, looks like five health there, five gold there, I should say. Okay. I don't want to buy really any of those. Oh, as I'm playing as Talkor, he's not over in his shop. That's actually hilarious. Okay, cool. Well, let's just head on out of here, I guess. I don't really want to buy anything. Let's max you out. Let's max you out. Let's max you out. Let's max you out. I want to use you. We'll begin. It's not really that good. We have this guy here. Okay, I mean, increased damage. That kind of sucks, because that means we'll lose 10 gold. But we get the increased damage, which could be useful. So I don't think I'm too worried about that. Ooh, here we go. 30 gold. Oh, that only gives us 3. I thought it would have gave us more. That's okay. That's okay. And then the smaller potions give us 2, the bigger potions give us 3. So I guess that's not terrible. Especially when we start getting like in the like wave 3 where you get like 20, 30 potions that drop on the ground. Like that'll be a huge huge increase and stuff. We do have a gold shrine as well, so let's see what we got going on there. Decent XP, nothing too crazy though. I mean, the damage isn't too bad. The more gold we're getting, the better off we're gonna be because it increases. I would like to try and get to 90 gold. That could be pretty crazy. And then anything over 90 gold we could spend because we'll have the bottomless pit at that point, or the bottomless bags or whatever they call it. Does that mean this will also give us gold? No. Okay. That would have been cool. But it doesn't. Alright, let's see here. Almost there. Okay. Lots of XP right here. I'm gonna try and pick all this up. Alright, not too bad. I do want the one where it shoots more projectiles. I think that was 45 gold. Like, how it's taking forever to clear this. Okay. There we go. Holy smokes, man. Oh, I almost got hit there. Holy crap, I wasn't paying attention. Like, I looked up at my map there and I almost got hit. Definitely not gonna get a whole lot of seedlings this run, but that's okay. It's only round one. I feel like as we get more experience in like his mastery, we'll unlock better stuff through that. That'll definitely help us out a lot. I mean, is that worth it? What do we lose? We'll lose 30% cooldown, 3 projectiles, 3 penetration, 50 area, 15 crit. 50 it's not even worth getting that XP one. I mean, we almost have everything maxed out. This costs us 3. Then we can max this out. We just need 2 more XP and then we're done. Oh, we got XP attraction as well that we can go for. So yeah, I'm not gonna worry about that. Wait, that's just XP. Oh, that's XP gain. So I mean, I don't think it's worth it. I think getting the 90 gold is way more profitable than spending 15 gold to get that, considering we almost have everything maxed out. Like, we could probably max everything out here in a couple of minutes. I mean, and we have next wave, so like, yeah, we're definitely gonna max things out. For sure. Oh, I don't know why I'm not popping my ult. Okay. Oh, I want that, but, oh, that gold ore. Oh, holy crap, dude. Gold disappears super quick with the bottomless bag. Holy smokes, dude. 2.75 seconds is fast. Jeez Louise, man. Okay. Alright. Talkor's an interesting, character. Pop that again. Ooh, we got, bad boy. Damage could be good. Attack speed could be good. Projectile speed could be good. I think I'm gonna go with projectile speed. Just so the coins fly faster. I mean, because damage, like, let's be honest, we're one-shotting just about everything other than the elites here. So I'm not too worried about any of that. I do want to head down to the gold mine. That's probably where we're gonna get a lot of our gold. Right now, 12? Yeah, he's already maxed out. Let's put us up to 49, or 51, oh wow. Okay, so we got like bonus gold, it looked like. Okay, we're on this guy. Okay, so we got an area, or a crit up increase. By 2%. Not great, not terrible. I mean, it is crit, so you can't say no to that. I do hate that it throws it in random areas. Like, if I'm close to this guy, it's not throwing it in his direction. It's just completely random. Okay, now it's throwing it in toward him. Okay. He's almost dead. Doing good. I do like this concept. It's definitely an interesting concept, because if you get hit, you lose gold. But if you get hit, yes, you lose gold, but you also lose your perks for whatever it may be. Like, you're losing your perk for like this stuff down here. So yes, you lose gold because gold is health, but if you get hit, we lose 10 gold, which means we'll drop down to 42, which means we lose out on 100% area and 5 penetration. So we definitely don't want to ever get hit, is basically what it's coming down to. Which is a very cool, interesting concept. Well, we don't have another upgrade here, because we haven't unlocked it yet. So maybe I'll go with one of these guys. Enemies that die have a 10% of creating another skull. Your other attacks have a 20% chance of summoning a new lightning bolt. Okay, I'll take that one. Let's level that up. Okay, that works. Cool. Ooh, you can't cheese it either. I was thinking, oh, maybe you could pop your ultimate and then just cheese it in here. And pop it again, but you can't. It only starts to cool down once you get into this area. Oh, increasing the area makes the coin massive. Okay, that's pretty cool. Okay, I think we need... We might need 5 more to max out the XP attraction. Duration cooldown, I'll take. Let's go this route. It's already... We already maxed it. Okay. I didn't think we maxed it yet. Oh, duh, because we leveled this up down here. That makes sense. Damage projectiles I'll take. I mean, we could get enough to max out... Okay, this isn't a bad one either. We got two things basically coming down from the sky after this. And then we have 2 projectiles that were thrown out from us. I forgot where I was going with the last one. So basically our next upgrade is going to be 75 gold. If we can get 75 gold, that'll be our next upgrade. Damn it. Dude, that stuff disappears quick. Very quick. Imagine if it was XP that disappeared. Holy smokes, dude. Not that it matters, because we have everything maxed out other than the tools or whatever. Yeah, let's try this. Let's level you up. Alright, probably gonna head back down to the gold mine. I might... Yeah, I'm not gonna spend the 15 gold. I already said that. Damn it. The dashes need to be further. Or I need to have more movement speed. No! Damn, we just lost like 10 gold there, or 5 gold there. So you still lose 5 gold, but we got the increase in damage. Interesting. Okay, cool. So I was thinking that we're gonna lose 10 gold. We only lost 5. That's actually pretty sweet. We have a ton of XP flowing around here. Not that it matters. I mean, it does kind of matter because we have these magic tools that we can use to upgrade. Oh my god. Getting a little overwhelmed here. Which kind of sucks because like we've maxed everything. Like we can't go anywhere else. Like this is it. This is the run. Bottomless pit I can definitely see definitely not always gonna take. Because we've lost out, I would say, on quite a bit of gold. Oh my gosh, the potions do disappear. Holy smokes, dude. I wasn't thinking the potions would disappear. They do. Dang, that kind of sucks. So you definitely need to be right on top of it. Okay. So yeah, definitely the bottomless bag is not... I mean, I can see it probably being good down the road. But for our circumstance right now, it's definitely not good. It definitely hurts us more than helping us right now. Definitely hurts us more than helping us. I come over here. Okay, that didn't pop. 7 gold. Okay. Not bad, not bad. Okay, well, here we go. I have no idea what we got from that crate. We got 59 gold. Kind of sucks, but hey, it is what it is. Let's run in here and see what we got with Lord Ragnar. See what he can make happen for us. Okay. Alright. Not doing a lot of damage, but slowly getting there. Okay. He might end up throwing a... okay, he doesn't shield on round one. Okay, I thought he did. That's okay, that works for us. Because he's dead. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, baby. Use the coin, the power of gold ascension. Golden statues, interesting. So yeah, that's been Talkor. Very interesting character. Hopefully y'all ended up enjoying that. When you dash, you turn nearby enemies into golden statues, plus 1 gold hearts. I'm gonna take this. Actually, plus 1 gold heart might not be a bad idea, but... Yeah. This has been Nordic Ashes. Hopefully y'all ended up enjoying. If so, make sure you tap that like button down below. If you guys are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Every little bit counts, so I do greatly appreciate it. And I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Peace out!